In surviving R. Kelly news.
Oh my god. Yo, I need to watch this. I need to watch
this. Yo, man.
This is a series?
Yes.
Oh, fuck! I forgot to bring it!
Oh, I forgot your money!
Oh, no, no. I got your money, too.
Wait, no, I don't. Fuck! That's what was in my backpack.
Don't you worry.
We fucking suck, dude.
He's like,
Fill us in. Like, what
I got the R. Kelly episodes, and then,
illegally? Is that what you're saying?
Legally.
Illegally?
First of all, anybody who...
Wait, no one goes legally and does this. This is a fucking lie move.
Huh?
Legally.
Dude, I don't do anything bad.
You don't do this when you're telling the truth.
What are you talking about?
Wait, it's not on Netflix?
No.
No. It's on...
It's on Lifetime.
It's on Lifetime.
You get it on Prime.
Oh, but you guys can get it.
It was gifted by a wonderful friend.
Yeah, so it was...
Pay like $2 per episode if you don't have cable.
No, we're fucking around. But yeah. Have you heard about this shit, though?
No.
Submitted by Dave Chappelle.
Oh my god, what? I love you!
Thank you, Dave Chappelle.
Show? Watch He's a fan.
That's where he gets his joke.
Dave Chappelle, how come you didn't comment on R. Kelly then? What's up, dude? You're one of the guys that didn't say anything.
R. Kelly is now under criminal investigation for the claims laid out in a recent docu-series.
He's so going to jail.
It's so funny that, finally.
That's fucked up, all these people, though.
I know.
Dude, that whole documentary should have been called I Should Have Said Something. Yeah. That's what that fucking documentary should have been called. But there are so many moments in this thing that it's not supposed to be funny, but it's kind of funny. Mm. Because, first of all, it's a Lifetime, so the documentary doesn't look that
it's
fucking
very dramatic.
Good. It's very overly dramatic.
Overly dramatic.
Because there's just, and they're trying to make it really serious, but because it's too dramatic, it becomes satirical. Mm. Like, for example, they go, R. Kelly was, he took advantage of these women, and they do a splice video of this.
Oh, yeah.
That's
true.
Okay,
what's it?
So I'm like, who the fuck edited this shit? It's hilarious.
I can't wait to watch it.
Yo, there's this one scene, if you don't fucking laugh at it, you're not my friend, because it's so fucking funny, because I was in the room cracking up, and then Ray was just mortified, but I was dying laughing.
So you guys aren't friends anymore?
Huh? I've disowned him. So there's a scene.
His roommate. You used to own him, huh?
So R. Kelly, he's being asked and interviewed, and they ask him so straight up, point blank, because it was during a controversial time, and they go, so you like teenage girls? Like straight up. Mm-hmm. And then his response was, well, what exactly is a teenager?
Oh, shit.
shit.
Not the right fucking answer. Like, he almost wanted to get caught. I heard in that scene, his manager goes, like this, don't answer the question, and he goes, I got this. What exactly is a teenager?
How do you define
Yeah, it was something like that.
It's like, you like drugs? How do you define drugs?
His manager's in the back like...
That's tight,
there's so many wild moments where it's not even like he was trying to hide it. He basically, he would chill around high schools.
Like, he went to high school to chill out like with high school girls.
I read about that because he knew the effect that he had on high school chicks. Like, if you already have pictures of him posted in your bedroom or whatever, when he goes to a high school, like, he just feels like a god.
Yeah. So I'm gonna tell you guys there's a list of 8 things. Let's see if we get through them all. Of the things that they covered in this docuseries.
Spoilers.
So the first one is that R. Kelly and his brother were reportedly molested as children. He did say back in 2012.
Yeah, if you're an R. Kelly fan, you know.
Yeah, he started being molested from around age 7 and continued into his early teens, and it was by a family member or something.
Yeah, repeatedly, like by multiple. And I heard that's what stunted him psychologically in maturity and also like...
Why he kickstarted his crazy ass sex drive too.
Yeah, and why he's also attracted to young girls and their quote unquote innocence, because they're like,
that was stolen from him.
Yeah, a lot of people who are victims of like molestation and rape and stuff like that at an early age, they tend to become predators themselves. Yeah. It's pretty weird, but it sucks. Yeah,
dude, Timbaland too. He's not too smart either. Because this fool put out
a producer?
Yeah, so this fool put out a statement apparently where he said, oh, you know, the whole R. Kelly situation, because he knew about it too. He goes, well, when I met Aaliyah as well, when I saw her, I also fell in love with her. And then he was like, but I knew because our age was different, like too much of an age gap, so, you know, I knew better. why would you put that out right now, dude? Like,
so weird.
No, I swear, every PR team doesn't know what they're doing now, dude. They're just like fucking it up for everybody. Why would you say that? Why would you say you felt
she was fine as fuck? I wanted to fuck, but she's 14 though, man.
That's basically what he said. It's like, come on,
well,
man.
Well, speaking of Aaliyah, the next point here is that R. Kelly forged documents to marry Aaliyah when she was 15 and he was 27. So like they wrote that she was 18. And then apparently she got pregnant and I don't know exactly what happened with that, but that she got pregnant by R. Kelly. And that's the reason why they got married. But then 2 months later or something like that, the marriage was annulled. I don't know
Aaliyah
what happened in the pregnancy.
Is an angel, dude.
She is. Leave her alone.
She's so pretty, dude. She was so pretty.
Yeah. Oh.
She had that rubber band around her waist in that music video. Yeah. Ooh, I don't know how she did that.
That was one of the first times I remember feeling sad by a celebrity death. Like, that shit affected me. I was like a teenager, like 12 or something. I don't know, but
she was so young.
Yeah, that affected me. It's so weird. Like, someone you don't know.
Wouldn't she be our age now? Were we like the same age?
Yeah, a little bit older.
She had to have been older than me.
She's in 95, she was 15. I mean, 94, she was 15.
Yeah, she's older than us, yeah.
Dude, so next thing is that, so the underage girl in that R. Kelly sex tape where he's peeing on this 14-year-old girl is a former, R. Kelly's former artist's niece.
Oof.
So her name is Sparkle, and she was best known for her 98 single, Be Careful. And so she introduced him, she introduced her niece to him, and then later on she finds out that she was having sex with him. For years. But years!
The reason why he got away though is because she didn't press charges or she didn't come out about
it. Or the mom. Yeah, he paid off the family.
Yeah, and then she didn't. The girl that got peed on?
Yeah. The girl that got peed on denied.
She didn't come out on it.
She was like, that's not me on the tape. But then everyone that knew her was like, that's you, dude.
I heard there's multiple videos of him peeing on girls, though.
That fool just loves pissing on people, dude.
Well, I mean, why record it? No, he said that he had they were saying it in the docuseries that he was telling his, like, camp people, like, I have a problem, man. I just can't stop recording myself. And, like, this is going to get me.
I want to get caught.
He pretty much was saying he had a problem with filming himself.
He likes the danger.
Yeah. He's like, this is.
You're so responsible. You gotta like charge your batteries and stuff. Like, there's times you try to film.
He set up the tripod and lights.
Oh god.
Damn, he's a DP.
No, he just himself.
No, that's what I mean. Like, he's a videographer. He gotta like make sure the mic's plugged in. You gotta charge the battery.
Would you ever let somebody pee on you?
What the fuck?
Well, it's not someone. It should be Casey.
Well, that's what I'm saying. Like, yeah, Casey.
If you love him.
Fuck. Where at though?
Yeah, like if it's on my foot, then all right.
Not on your foot. Whatever R. Kelly did, shower you. Golden shower.
Not in the face.
I saw the video.
You can take a shower.
This girl's a bold one right there.
Yeah, you can take a shower.
I saw the video.
It's nasty, but.
But I was underage when I saw it.
So it turned you on when you saw it?
No, I was.
Oh,
I
so
was.
It wasn't like.
It was sad. No, because my friend downloaded it and he's like, yo, I got the video. So we all were like huddling around the fucking, you know, computer to see what was going on, and it was all of it was like it looked like a normal sex tape up until the end when he pees on her and the.
How does he pee on her? Is she like laying
she's
down?
Just, no, she's just like on her knees and like he's just peeing on her.
Is it in her face?
I don't remember that part. All I remember thinking was
they were saying
does he have tarp or something because there's gonna be pee all over that carpet.
Did he pee after he busted nuts?
I don't remember that part. All I just remember is that they were in a bedroom.
Question.
They were just in a bedroom and he was peeing on her. And we're all just like, oh, we can't watch it anymore, man.
Did he pee with the boner? Because that's hard.
That's what I was saying. That's how did he bust nuts first?
He's doing that. Because you know when you
pee. It was like the.
You see her face? Like, was she really little? Like, you could tell.
I don't remember the details because this was over 15 years ago.
So sad. Yeah. That's why
you could clearly tell that person was young.
Damn.
Cause if he peed with her with the boner, that shit was like a fucking fire hydrant. Just got her ass.
That's crazy.
You see her skin like cave in from the fucking like hard ass stream.
The water shit.
It's like a water jet.
It was gross, yeah.
Imagine she's all gagging too.
She should like be on a roller chair. She's just moving back.
It's
you
like
guys
that
are
game at the carnival.
All my fucking thoughts,
you know the
I
game
swear.
At the carnival where you hit it? It's the fucking horse.
The fucking balloon gets
bigger. Yeah, exactly what it is, dude. Oh, yeah. Dude, I really gotta see this video.
You guys are fucking saying all my.
I'm curious too, but then the fact that she's so little is just so sad that I'm like, I don't want to see.
Oh,
that.
We can't. It's child pornography.
Right. I mean, what he's doing is getting all the girls that are throwing themselves at him. Like, if you watch just snippets of the interview, there's like girls that are like, oh. You know how naive I was, but I was like trying to be a singer, and this was my big break. And then at the same time, I didn't know I was just so in love with them. So like
young
he's
and naive.
Taking advantage of his his godness toward them. So that was the part where it's like they'll do anything for him.
I heard Brooke Shields too when she was younger.
She was gorgeous.
There was like a photographer that took photos of her nude, but she was like super underage.
Oh shit.
Yeah, I heard like some shit like that
too. I'm sure that happened in old Hollywood all the fucking time, dude. You hear of all the child actors that are getting like, they would go to all these adult parties and shit, and they were boys. They were just getting passed around with all the execs, and they were
like,
just raping.
Corey Feldman?
Feldman, yeah.
He's coming out with the movie or documentary.
A lot of, both Corey.
There's a conspiracy of Hollywood child actor sex scandal things where like, there's a bunch of producers and I guess executives that are boy molesters. And then, you know, they would get young child actors and then like pass them around and shit.
Yeah.
Like they would get power of attorney from their parents. So then, and then they would kind of like convince their parents like, oh no, you know, like we got to work long hours. Oh, we'll take care of it.
That sucks.
And then the parents are such like fame chasing stage parents that they're like pretty much they'll let for fame. And then all these kids, when they're growing up, that shit would happen. And then, I guess like they would confine in Michael Jackson and shit like that, or like. And then something happened to Macaulay too. And then he confined
it
in Michael Jackson.
He's fucking weird now too.
They're supposed to come out with a documentary or movie about it, but there's like some shit going down behind the scenes where they're trying to prevent it from happening.
Gag them.
Because the guys that are in power today that were molesting, they're still existing. So I think like the Weinstein is just a
tip of the iceberg.
It's a small
the tip of the dick.
Like you go you know, women being taken advantage of. It's kind of like that happens. Now here's the R. Kelly thing.
But it's even worse because then it's like children.
Now it's gonna be children.
Thank God it's all coming out.
It's gonna be goats and children, I bet you.
Who's gonna stick up for the goats?
Yep.
Not me. Goats are devils and I don't care about them.
Oh, that's right. They got the devil eyes. Yeah, fuck them, dude.
But the baby kids, the kids are cute though.
Leave the goats alone.